LaunchDarkly is so much more than just turning on and off features inside of your environment. We also give you the tools to be able to measure how effective those features are against the metrics and goals that you have inside of your business. You can bolt on a product experiment to any feature flag you're releasing inside of your environment. And in one of our previous videos, we showed the idea of rolling out a feature that controls our early access program. This early access program gives our customers access to new products within the store. And each one of those product headers has a phrase in it, new in this case, to show these are new products. I want to play with changing that text and try to understand if changing it to something else actually results in more people purchasing from our store, purchasing those items inside of it. Within LaunchDarkly, I'm going to scroll down to this featured product label feature. This is a multivariate flag that contains different phrases for the top part of that card. Right now it's running as new, but you can see I have special, sale, or no header at all. I'm taking my entire user population and applying 25% to each one of those variations to serve them out to users. And I've created an experiment that will help me measure how effective each one of those is. When I turn this feature on now, it's available to the users inside of my environment. So when I go in and I refresh the application, log back in and re-enroll, you can see I'm getting a slightly different experience. That header is gone, so I've fallen in to the none variation. I'm gonna refresh this again, log back in one more time, enroll again, and we can see now I'm getting sale. This experiment's running inside of the environment. We can see it phrased down here. Determine how the wording on the accent label affects the customer's decision to purchase. When I select on this, I can see a quick glance at everything about this product experiment that's running inside of the environment. My primary metric is the add to cart click. So when someone clicks on that add to cart option, I'm capturing that metric and relating it back to the variation that they received. I'm also capturing a secondary metric around the checkout click, just to show when people actually finish the checkout process. I can quickly dive into results and see how this data is turning out inside of my LaunchDarkly environment. In our case, we can see the four different variations that are at play and a rough capture of the users who have interacted with that add to cart button within each one of those pools. I can scroll down further and see a chart indicating how successful each one of these are. We can see that special is edging out ahead of sale, and both of those are vastly outperforming new and none. With this data, we can start to tune our application, tune our website to drive more people through our conversion metric. From here, we might want to run the A/B test where we compare between special and sale and see how each one of those perform independent of these other four, since we know that special and sale are drastically outperforming the other. Using secondary metrics allows us to make sure the changes we're making to our primary metric don't negatively impact the rest of the experience of the website. Product experimentation has a ton of use cases. You really want to be creating an experiment whenever you're rolling out a feature inside of the environment so you can capture data around how that feature is performing and make sure that you're making the best decision for your application and for your business. Do you want to learn more? We'd love to hear from you. Reach out to us anytime.